will never be the same.
Don't you know your life will turn around?
Resurrection power is here.
Beloved, we welcome you to another exciting week on the Voice of Resurrection devotional. We are coming to the end of 2014. Can you believe it? How has your year been? Hey, you still have 7 days to make corrections and catch up on things that God ministered to you to do. Here is a word for somebody. He said, don't postpone to next year. Act now. Do it now. That's a word. Just at least one person, you see. It's very important, and when revelation comes to us, we obey. It's very important that when God gives us unction, that we act on it. Delayed obedience is disobedience. But beyond the legalities and the rules, beloved, you miss incredible miracles and blessings when you don't act at the moment you are supposed to act. Amen. We want to pick up a Christmas story. We just want to spend the next 3 days concluding the thought about our joy returning, because we are moving in line with the will of God. That Jesus appears in adverse circumstances. He arrived on the earth in very, very difficult circumstances, not congenial whatsoever. And so he's born now. God chooses the shepherds and broadcast the good news to them. May you be a candidate for God's visitation in Jesus' name. Remember, only shepherds receive the angelic visit. Remember that when Jesus rose from the dead, he didn't appear to everyone. He only appeared to his disciples that were chosen. And I'm asking you today, would you qualify for a visitation? Whether it's an angelic visitation or the Holy Spirit's visitation or the Lord Jesus coming himself. Kenneth Copeland has even talked about Jesus visiting him. And he's given height descriptions and, you know, features and whatever. I don't know that I need that. What I need is his presence, his communion, his strength, his wholeness. All that God packaged in him is what I desire to receive. And if I get a physical visitation, that will be fantastic. Glory to God. And now, the word today, though, is you must get up and act. The year is not over. You must get up and act. Let us look at our story once again. Verse 13 of Luke chapter 2. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men. And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord had made known unto us. Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing the Lord has made known to us. It is time to get up and act. I have discovered, beloved, that one of the most treacherous things Satan can do is to gut your own faith of its power. Where now you don't have any confidence in the prayers you're praying, you don't have confidence that God loves you enough to answer you. And then you become hopeless and start looking everywhere else for help. Yes, God has given men giftings and graces in specialized areas. And we need them and their grace to factor into our lives in crisis. But as they come to help, they must find faith there. You must still hold on to your own faith. See, because it says, when you are afflicted, you should pray. And as I've said 1,000 times in my CDs and in the sanctuary, that him must believe in him's prayers would deliver him from him troubles. Is any among you afflicted? Let him pray. And so when you are in faith, you will respond to the word spoken. When doubt and unbelief has taken a hold of you, you will doubt every word spoken. You will question every word spoken. You will begin to seek endless confirmations. But these shepherds were afraid, and they saw for themselves the angels of the Lord, you know, celebrating Jesus' arrival, and they pronounced great tidings of great joy to the shepherds. And as soon as the angels departed, they said, you know what? We believe what was spoken, and we must get up and act. We must leave our sheep and go to Bethlehem to see this. I'm sure that they probably put the sheep in the care of caretakers. But beloved, you must respond to the heavenly vision. You must respond to heavenly visitation. How many times, beloved, have people spoken to me and told me what God said and never acted on it? How many times have I spoken by revelation and people say, well, you know, the Lord told me that. Then what stopped you from acting? Unbelief has set in. The overwhelming circumstance has drained you of courage, of your get up and go. May God give it back to you this morning in Jesus' name. You must get up and act. You must get back into that school. You must call those debt collectors and face them down and believe God for help in this difficult time. You must do what the Spirit is unctioning you to do. You cannot ignore your moment. You cannot ignore the word of the Lord. If you are like me, you are believing for groceries, and God starts speaking to me about flying airplanes, then believe him and act. If you are going through difficult times and blessings are being pronounced, don't reject the word. Don't curse them out. Don't get angry. Thank God for the word of breakthrough. Thank God for the word of deliverance. Finish this year strong. Don't finish weak. Yes, there's heaviness. There's all these things happening, but don't get overwhelmed. Get up and act. Get up and act in Jesus' name. Get up and act. Just do it. Nike didn't invent it. Mary, the mother of Jesus, said that thousands of years ago to the disciples, whatsoever he says for you to do, just do it. That's your word for this morning. Get up and act. Just do it. I read it one more time before I go. And it came to pass as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another. I love a cloud of witnesses and environment of faith. Let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord had made known unto us. Beloved, if they did not believe what was said, they will not act. Do you believe? We'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Waiting on you. Yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is, yes, he is.